otherwise, you would need to go to Egypt, right?
Yeah.
And then how long did you
take? So the pilot said, otherwise, it would be 7 hours.
7 hours, okay. Now, yeah, because it's outdoor and hot, so it's not really checking. I can wear it if you mind. I can wear it.
I don't care.
Sure? Yeah. Okay, okay, okay. Because I totally respect that. Yeah, yeah, even up. Was it PC awesome?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it's done. It's very good. Yeah.
Good afternoon. actually pretty present all day throughout. But I was here last year just to thank the Crown Prince for the UAE's assistance to recovering an American hostage from Yemen, Danny Birch. I can tell you the Crown Prince, Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed, is a friend to be counted upon. It is especially remarkable that we have flown here directly from Israel, Ben Gurion Airport, on the first ever commercial flight to Abu Dhabi. This flight was made possible by the UAE's recent historic agreement with Israel, the Abraham Accords, which normalized relations between America's most reliable and most capable partners in the region. These two great nations are in the process of exchanging ambassadors and are cooperating on a broad range of fields, including finance, education, healthcare, trade, and security. This will unleash economic growth in both countries. The combination of Israeli know-how and high-tech and the UAE's capital and financial centers is going to create something very, very special in the Middle East. On the religious and cultural front, Muslims who wish to pray at the Al-Aqsa Mosque will now be able to fly from Abu Dhabi directly to Tel Aviv, and they will be welcomed. We're truly impressed by the leadership exhibited by the UAE and by the Crown Prince in this effort to make peace. Without his vision and without his courage, the Abraham Accords would not be possible. This agreement represents the most significant step toward peace in the Middle East in over 25 years. At long last, nations have put aside old ideas and old grievances and embraced a better future, a future of shared interests and shared goals. Working together, the UAE and Israel will be more secure than ever. Together, they'll form a united front with the United States against Iran. We believe that additional Arab and Muslim countries will soon follow the United Arab Emirates lead and normalize relations with Israel. This trend will put the region on a truly transformative path of stability, of security, and of opportunity. Thanks to the courage and leadership of Crown Prince Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed, Prime Minister Bibi Netanyahu, and President Donald Trump, a new era has truly begun for our three nations. And these leaders will now be known throughout history as peacemakers. I want to thank Jared and his team, Special Representative Buck, Special Envoy Berkowitz, our NSA team, our NSC team of Mark Vandroff, Rob Greenway, Miguel Correa, Alex Gray, for their excellent efforts in helping to assist Jared and myself as we go out to help bring the party together. But the real credit here goes to the Israelis and the Iraqis. And I'm very pleased to share the stage with Jared and Shabbat, who also was on the historic flight from Tel Aviv with us. So Abu Dhabi has become one of the great capital cities of the world, not just in the region, but the entire globe. I'm truly looking forward to my stay here in the Emirates and working with my Iranian and American and Israeli colleagues. Thank you. May God bless the UAE and may God bless America.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أنا فخور وفرحان جدا بوجودي هنا كرئيس الوفد الإسرائيلي. وصلنا هنا من شان تحويل رؤية إلى واقع. لا حدود للتعاون الذي ممكن نتطور بمجالات العلم، الابتكار، الساحة، الطيران، الزراعة، الطاقة ومجالات كثيرة أخرى. نادعو دول أخرى للمشاركة معنا بعملية صانع السلام من أجل كافة شعوب المنطقة. شكرا لمضيفينا الإماراتيين ولشركائنا الأمريكيين على قيادتهم وعلى زعامتهم. أنا نرجاش لعمود بروش المشلحات الإسرائيلية الرسمية لإيحود الإميريات العربية. וגם לכאן נציגים בכירים של ממשלת ישראל ואנוכי הדל בטיסה מסחרית ישירה היסטורית. הגענו לאור יום ולעיני כל במטוס הנושא דגל ישראל ביחד עם ידידינו האמריקאים אשר להם תפקיד מפתח בכינון השלום. בשם ראש ממשלת ישראל בנימין נתניהו, אני מבקש להודות לנשיא ארצות הברית דונלד טראמפ ולשליחו ג'ארד קושנר וצוותו, כמו גם לעמיתי היקר רוברט אובריין, היועץ לביטחון לאומי של נשיא ארצות הברית, על החזון, על התבונה ועל המאמצים שהשקיעו כדי שנגיע לרגע הזה. רבע מאה חלפה מאז נחתם הסכם השלום האחרון בין מדינה ערבית לישראל. השנים הרבות שחלפו לא ריפו ידיים ולא הכניסו את התמיהה לכך. ברצוני להביע בפני מארחי, ובראשם הוד מעלתו שייח מוחמד בן זייד, נסיך הכתר של איחוד האמירויות, את הערכתנו על צעדו האמיץ. לישראל ולאיחוד האמירויות הרבה מן המשותף. אזורנו רווי אתגרים ואיומים, אבל יש בנו את העוז ואת היכולת לעמוד בפניהם. זאת, הודות לרוח האדם המפעמת בנו, לראייה החזונית, לדמיון לחשוב בגדול, ליכולת לחדש, לרצון להצליח, לנכונות להשתנות, ולאמונה שבכוחנו לשנות את המציאות. אנו נושאים עינינו לאופק חדש באזור. אופק של שיתוף פעולה בין חברות מתקדמות. אופק של טכנולוגיה, של חדשנות, של סגסוג, של צמיחה ושל תקווה. לא בכדי אנו קוראים להסכם הזה ולנוספים שיבואו בעקבותיו הסכמי אברהם. אברהם, אבינו הראשון, נשא חזון חדשני. הוא יצא נגד המסמרות והאמונות שרפו בימיו ולפניו. ייסד את האמונה באל אחד, האל שהבטיח לו להיות מקור הברכה לכולנו, ונברכו בך כל משפחות האדמה. בבואנו לכונן את היחסים בין ישראל לאמירויות, אנו שואבים השראה מאבינו המשותף ופורצים לדרך חדשה, דרך אמיצה, דרך של תקווה, של שותפות, של אחווה, של סגסוג ושל שלום.
Mr. Jared, welcome to the UAE. How does this peace accord support peace and throughout the region? And my second question is, how did it feel to you personally? How did it feel to you personally to be on the first ever commercial flight from Tel Aviv to Abu Dhabi?
Thank you very much for the welcome. I believe that this agreement has the ability to change the whole course of the Middle East. For the last 3.5 years that I've been working on different issues in the Middle East, there's been a lot of sense of hopelessness. The last decades we've had conflict and war and division. And what happened here was three great leaders came together and they started writing the script for a new Middle East. President Trump worked very closely with Prime Minister Netanyahu and Crown Prince Mohammed bin Zayed. And they said, we don't have to, the future doesn't have to be by the past, and so they showed a lot of courage, they worked together, and we realized that most people want the same thing. They want the ability to live a better life, they want to have a better job, they want to live in peace, and we're all sons of the same God. So for me to fly over here today was a tremendous honor. My grandparents survived the Holocaust. They were persecuted because of their faith in Nazi Germany in the 1940s. And they came to America, and they were able to experience freedom, and that enabled them to live the American dream and have a great life. And I'm very fortunate today to work for a great president of the United States, and to be a part of this delegation that took this historic flight shows that barriers that exist can be broken if we only have the courage and the optimism and the vision to see them through.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Do you have a message for the Palestinians today?
The message that we carry for the Palestinians is also one of hope. We've done a lot of great work to lay out a pathway for them to improve their future. We've put an offer to their leadership on the table that will enable them to have a stake very excited to help lift them up and move them forward, but they can't be stuck in the past. They have to come to the table. They have to figure out how do we do something that benefits everybody and allow everyone to move forward. So again, peace will be ready for them and opportunity will be ready for them as soon as they're ready to embrace it.
And last one,
Mr. Kushner, it seems apparent, based on the statements on the plane and statements you've made in the past, that the U.S. is preparing for the possibility or perhaps even the probability of selling the F-35 to the United Arab Emirates.
Wouldn't that give two countries a QME in the Middle East? Would that defeat the purpose of the QME? And would you consider selling the F-35 to other countries in the region if the circumstances were right?
United Arab Emirates has a very special defense relationship with America that goes back 30 years. They have tremendous capability. America and the United Arab Emirates work on tremendous missions together. They've accomplished incredible things. Right now, the biggest threat in the region that we see is Iran. You know, when President Trump came into office, ISIS had a caliphate the size of Ohio. There was a lot of funding that was going to terrorism, and there were a lot of people who were using the internet to radicalize youth. President Trump has worked very closely with the leaders of the UAE and the other Gulf states and other Arab leaders to try and bring the region closer together. The caliphate of ISIS, the physical caliphate, has been taken back, and now we're focused on the future and what advancements we can make. So the military relationship that America has with the United Arab Emirates is very special, just as the relationship that America has with Israel is incredibly special. And so the QME is something that can be respected while also advancing our military relationship with the United Arab Emirates. And we'll be talking more about that over the coming weeks and months. But, you know, today is about celebrating this historic breakthrough, which enables opportunities for the people to come closer together, for people from the technology sector, from the economy, from the agricultural sector, even for the security sector to start working together. So the thing that brought everyone together is that there are a tremendous amount of common opportunities between the countries, and it's within the interests of both countries to move forward, and that's why both leaders showed the courage to make the historic step that we are taking today.